baby, stay strong, we gon' live long. I don't wanna ruin this one, this type of love don't always.
Broadcasting live, 2K Sports presents the NBA. It's Monday night. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And joining us on the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. D.A., it's all yours.
Kevin, thank you. There is no question that Dallas's Luka Doncic has captured league-wide admiration. The Hall of Famer player and executive Jerry West said, "We are watching genius, a superstar who will go down as the best player in Mavs franchise history." Considering Dirk Nowitzki was there for a long time, Kevin, the praise from Jerry doesn't get much higher or from a loftier perch.
Indeed. Something special, David. Thanks. Here's a look at the schedule now for Dallas. On Monday, they'll be taking on Paul Millsap and the Denver Nuggets. Then on Wednesday, they'll be matching up against Mike Conley and the Utah Jazz.
And if I'm this team, I'm looking at this as a barometer to see how we stack up against some of the top teams in the league. They'll have to be at their best, but if they come out of this with some success, I think it'll build momentum for the rest of the run.
Now, a look at Dallas's starting lineup. Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Tim Hardaway Jr. out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Cauley Stein in at the five. And for the Nets, the front court spots filled by Harrison Durant. Irving is out there with Harden, and it's Jordan in at the center position. Well, Greg, with your son getting drafted, you joined the ranks of some historic NBA father-son duo.
You know, I got the opportunity to play with Arvydas Sabonis in Portland and remember DeMontis as a little kid.
No
and now
kidding.
He's an all-star last year. You know, I think you're going to have an influx of that in the coming years. Dwayne Wade's son is a terrific player. We know about LeBron's son's ability. He's possibly heading to the league one day. You just never know. I'm as a dad, it's going to get the opportunity to watch his son play excited, but... I think you're going to see more of this in the future.
Cole and Greg Anthony. I like the way that sounds. Now, here's Doncic after the miss from KD. And Doncic, here we go. And now the fast break. Irving with the ball. And there's the call on Kyrie Irving. That is his first foul of the game.
You got to be in control when you go to the rack. And he was not. You can't just run guys over.
They're going to turn it over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time. Harris outside. Back to Irving. Jordan with a screen on Cauley Stein. Shot's good by Durant.
Well, Kyrie Irving has such a good sense of when his teammates are going to create an opportunity, and he puts the pass on time and on target.
And Doris, last season for Kyrie Irving, really one of waiting. No Durant on the year to play off of, and then Kyrie's season with the Nets was cut short due to injury.
Well, second surgery for Irving in the last 3 years. You obviously hope he and KD...
Oh, wow!
Young fella. And this is how a floor leader makes a statement. Harden just put the other team on notice.
Here's Hardaway. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's on Kevin Durant.
And when you watch Hardaway shoot, one thing that stands out, he has a very quick release.
And, Greg, that's what makes the jumper very tough to contest, especially when he's dialing it up from range. You have to stay connected to this guy defensively. It's not easy to do with the other weapons on this team.
And he makes the first.
Tim Hardaway Jr. to me is a terrific all-around player, right? He can score it, he can pass it, he'll rebound the position. There's a lot to like about his game.
Hardaway. Hardaway hits them both. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Now, here is Irving, coming off a solid outing against Miami. Harden's shot is off. Now, Doncic. Going inside, and the dunk by Doncic.
Well, Luka can get himself into the paint with consistency, and boy, does he make that a high percentage finish.
Well, it was the Dallas Mavericks in their last game, a loss to Houston. Harden draws the double. On the wing, Harris. Tips it, and there's Jordan, putting it right back in.
It is not easy trying to keep DeAndre Jordan off the boards. His combination of length and determination, so impressive.
The drive by Doncic. Goes straight through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. It's going to be on DeAndre Jordan.
And Doncic was part of a draft day trade that so far seems to have worked out pretty well for both teams.
That's exactly right. Doncic, Greg, was selected by Atlanta with the third pick. He was then quickly shipped to Dallas for the fifth overall pick, which turned into Trae Young, plus a future pick. Neither of these young men wasted any time putting their stamp on the NBA. I do think their futures will always be discussed in connection with the other.
Last outing for the Nets. They won that game against Miami.
Yeah, and that...
Wow, looks like 2017 when DeAndre came home with the dunk contest trophy. Makes it look easy there.
To the left wing, a three from Porzingis. Jordan with the rebound. And it's Harden with the ball for the Nets. Trailing by two. Shoots over Brunson. It's rebounded by Porzingis. Here's Brunson. Harden with it. There's the triple. It doesn't go for him. It's been all about Luka Doncic for the Dallas Mavericks. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Back right after this. Naturally a ball-dominant player, James Harden talked to us about others setting him up a little bit more.
Yeah, that's the goal. Of course, I run off the ball is something that I'm comfortable doing. Like, I'm able to catch and shoot. I'm able to play off, you know, on the wings.
Giving their offense another dynamic.
And it also helps him preserve some energy for those big moments in the big games.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Mavericks?
They've gotten to the line with tremendous consistency here through the first period.
And this is why coaches say be aggressive. As long as you're playing smart, good things tend to happen, even if you're on the road.
Green is out there with Luwawu. Then it's Jordan. Then there's Irving. And it's Harden in at the two. So that's the Nets five. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, thanks. Since the Nets acquired Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant, the franchise has gone from being an up-and-comer to a potential powerhouse in the East. That's necessitated changes on the bench and on the court, as the Nets have added some new veterans. The time is now for Brooklyn to stand up and make its move in the East. Kevin, back to you.
Well, we'll see how they do. David, thank you. Greg, so many people know your story, born and raised in Las Vegas. It must have been an amazing feeling then to lead UNLV to its only championship.
I mean, Kevin, you know, playing in front of so many people you know has its pros and cons.
Right.
But to be a part of that 1990 championship team and the only one we've been able to hoist and to have my jersey hanging in that rafter, it's humbling and, yes, it brings back a lot of fond memories.
Like historically good, right? When you think of that team, what that meant, it has a historic place.
It does. We felt like we were able to etch our mark in terms of the lures of the game of college basketball.
Here's Doncic. Just five on the clock. Green against Hardaway. and they'll turn it over. Could not get off his shot. 24-second violation. Here we get a moment to view the league's highest scoring teams. Number one, the Nets.
I mean, it's an exciting brand of basketball that they're playing. They've got such deadly weapons. Teams have had a heck of a time trying to slow them down.
The Nets have gone 2-for-4 shooting the ball here in the second.
I got the air, outside.
Brunson against Irving. Three-pointer. A second chance effort. And Jordan with the layup. Jordan's got 6 points.
Just tremendous execution right there. DJ feeling out the defense and doing damage inside.
Doncic, no good. Brooklyn's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. That's tipped. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. And a quick look at some of the numbers for him.
And guys, his effective field goal percentage is trending in the wrong direction over the past 5 games. Shot discipline hasn't been the best. He'll be looking to play a smarter game tonight.
Brunson finds Doncic. It's Cauley-Stein, top of the key. Out to Doncic. And there's the drive. The shot by Cauley-Stein, no good.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. Boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
Out left to the wing. Pass to Green. From deep, Harden. Happy to see that one go in after missing 6 of his 9 shots today.
And without a doubt, one of the most advanced scorers this game has ever seen. Harden can do damage from just about anywhere.
It's good, and the Brooklyn lead is cut down to 1 on the bucket from Doncic.
What a terrific play by just a tremendous all-around player. This guy makes it look easy.
And the foul called on Tim Hardaway Jr. That is his first foul of the game. And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. Durant.
And that stifling defense of Cauley-Stein is what got him drafted 6th back in 2015.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Nets lead by 1. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot. Kyrie, what were you all focusing on coming into the game tonight?
So I come out with a intense focus and intensity that other teams can't match. Just doing whatever it takes to keep our tempo. Guys are in a great rhythm when we have a great tempo. So just trying to get everybody involved and do whatever it takes to win.
Well, we'll see if you can keep playing at your pace in the second half. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Brooklyn found themselves in a close game in the first. Some good moments from both teams, but as the first period wrapped up, they trailed by 2. They were a determined team in the second quarter, and you saw it come across on the scoreboard. Kenny, your thoughts on the Nets' first half?
Man, their fans know how to give their team a lift, that's for sure. The atmosphere in this building has been amazing, but the fans still have some work to do. They've got to keep the noise up, keep the energy up, and carry their guys to the win.
And Shaq, what did you see from Dallas?
Well, their reserves haven't contributed much. It's fine to ask your starters to do the hell of it, don't leave them out in the cold. I think this could easily become a bigger issue as the game wears on.
That about wraps it up. Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game that's been so far. You have to like what you're seeing from Luka Doncic.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
One of the things every player is after is efficiency at the offensive end. And boy, this young guy has done just that.
On the floor for Dallas, Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Hardaway is out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Cauley-Stein in at the 5 spot. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Doncic. Let's check out the Western Conference standings right now that we're here in the new year. Let's take a look at Dallas. They're down in ninth place so far, still early in the season.
You know, right now, Dallas, they're a team searching for a way to take a leap forward this season. So far, here in the early going, that leap has not existed.
Yeah, it hasn't been all bad, though. I mean, they've had some nice wins, and even if they're not an elite-level team, they still have the look of a playoff team.
Hey, Greg, if you could coach one team right now, who would it be?
That's a tough one. Clippers, Lakers, Bucks. You know what? I would probably go Lakers or Bucks because you would have an opportunity to coach someone who arguably might be considered the best to ever play the game, because I think Giannis is trending in that direction and LeBron obviously already is.
How about a guy like Kemba Walker and coaching the Celtics, having him to do what you want to do on the floor?
He'd be brilliant. And Kemba, one of the most underrated leaders in our game. Great, great human being.
Well, coming into the league with immense potential, Porzingis has already fulfilled much of it, already an all-star. But, you know, Greg, there are still areas he's working on.
Yeah, he's definitely getting stronger and more physical. You'd like to see him make the next pass a little more often when a teammate has a better shot. But if he can just stay healthy, boy, the sky's the limit on what he can accomplish.
The three from Harden. It's rebounded by Dallas. Cauley Stein's got his fifth rebound in this one. Doncic kicks to Porzingis. For the lead, the drive by Doncic. He lays it in. Doncic has got 18 points in the game.
There's a burst that allows Luka Doncic to be effective on his drives. You're not going to catch him standing around. This guy is in attack mode.
Too open that time. Made it look too easy.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
On the wing, Doncic. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Let's take this chance to bring you now the hottest shooters from downtown this month. In the third spot, Jeff Green and, of course, Joe Harris.
I mean, the shooting range of these two guys has probably been the most impressive. There's not a spot on the floor they can't hit from.
Here's Harden. Rebounded by Hardaway.
Well, when you've been struggling as he has, you love that your teammates have really stepped up and taken the challenge.
They are on fire right now. That's four straight makes.
To the inside. And finished off by Katie.
Well, the size and height of Kevin Durant makes him a prime threat to throw it down. You've got to keep him out of the paint.
And here's Doncic from the arc.
Well, after hitting one triple in the first half, it's been all radio silence since.
Harden up top. He has seven. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
Really in a good position thanks to the accuracy from beyond.
Stolen by Harden.
And no need to rush this. Let the clock run down.
Well, it's trying to close the quarter strong, and by that, take a great shot without giving them an opportunity for another one down the other end.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Brooklyn shooting their first free throws of the game right now.
And they've shot the ball well this season in terms of their attempts, 81%.
Well, you can be a second-round selection and still make it in the NBA. Joe Harris, because of his commitment to work, has carved out a nice career for himself. This guy is a lights-out three-point shooter.
Good on the second free throw. Mavericks trail by four. And Doncic, here we go. Brunson, good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Brunson's got eight.
Boy, there is an artistry and a feel to Luka Doncic's game. This guy is elite with his playmaking.
And here's KD for three. Three quarters of play in a close game here. Nets out in front, up one. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. How about a look at today's State Farm Assist of the Game?
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
Three tense quarters behind us, one more to go. Thanks for being with us as we begin the fourth. The front court spots filled by Harrison Durant. Brown out there with Landry Shamet, and it's Green in at the five, roaming the paint. So that's the Nets' five.
Doncic has been in this position many times. He makes it look easy.
Pass to Durant. In the corner, it's Harris. The three-pointer off the mark.
Boy, a wide open shot from his favorite spot. That is one he'd like to have back.
Here's Doncic, and the dunk by Doncic.
There's a certain resiliency to this team, and you're starting to see it.
No doubt, keeping it very close. They're going to have to step up even more to get over the hump here.
Brown outside. Here's Harris. The basket good off the assist from Durant.
Joe Harris, confident, fearless, big-time shot delivery.
And so it's Porzingis. He'll bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks. It's a one-point game.
Just the kind of play they need in a game this close.
You know, that's the kind of aggression they want from their floor leader.
Boy, and not just the aggression, the ability to get to the rim, but how about the finish with intention?
Here's KD. And they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Big moments. This is who Kevin Durant is. He delivers when the game is in the balance.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Mavericks.
When they've had a chance to attack the basket at any point in this game, they've taken advantage.
Yeah, something else that stands out tonight is how many assists they have.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets. Jordan, he's checked in for Green. James Harden comes in for Landry Shamet. And Irving subbed in for Bruce Brown. Free throw drops for KD.
And really just a great rhythm at the line, whether it's a big lead in the first quarter or with the game hanging in the balance.
The drive by Doncic. And Doncic throws it down.
Just focusing on the task at hand, that's all you can do.
Boy, the tide is running one way and then shifts back in the other direction. I've lost count of how many lead changes we've had here tonight.
With the drive, Durant, that's good.
Now, how about Kevin Durant on the dribble drive? What to do with this guy? He's got so many ways he can hurt you.
Here's Doncic. Rebounded by the Nets. Let's a floater go, and he's able to get it back. And it's good for two. Durant's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Well, how about the persistence of KD? He knows he has the size and the reach to keep those possessions alive.
Doncic uses the glass to finish the layup.
And that's about the worst defense I can imagine a team playing coming down the stretch.
You know, we talk about execution offensively coming down the stretch. To me, it's as important defensively, and they didn't have it.
A moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Luka Doncic.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what the Nets head coach was going over with his team. And he's pushing them to empty the tank. He said, I know you're tired and it's been a tough game, but we can't hold back. If you're tired, come out. Otherwise, I want you full speed, guys.
Oh, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
To me, more often than not, when you attack, good things happen.
Come to me, come to me. KD looking around. 43 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Jordan sets the pick for Durant. Down low. And denied. He sends it right off the glass.
Hey, y'all, hold up.
Irving against Doncic. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
We are talking about a clever scorer. Luka Doncic has developed such a knack for getting to the free throw line.
He gets the first, that makes it a three-point lead. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a four-point ball game.
He knew what was riding on those foul shots and didn't mess around, making this a two-possession game.
Here is Durant. And again, it's the Nets missing. And now we've got the intentional foul.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
He hits the first one, and that puts them up by 5.
And what I like about Cauley-Stein is just how hard he plays. Really, both ends, a scrappy player.
Irving kicks to Harden. It's in, and he has brought them to within 2 points.
That's one of those clutch shots he's known for. When the pressure is high, he seems to be the most locked in.
Shoots. Oh, no good. And here's Harris from the arc. Can't get the 3 to fall. So a close game sees Dallas taking this one. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And now let's go over to David Aldridge from the sideline for an interview with our player of the game. Hey, David.
Thanks, Kevin. Luka, you played well and you got the win. So what made the difference?
Yeah, I think we had a great game. You know, I think it was a great game today. You know, we step up together, play good defense, and it was a great win.
Thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.